just picking up on that, I mean, on that point, and it's one that you made before actually about Alberto's, you know, ability as a vocalist. I mean, this song is obviously was very personal to you, but just, I mean, in general, he's a fabulous singer.
Oh God,
I think on Love Is the Light, on the tour, because that was a new song, I think it really suddenly became very clear what he has brought to the band in his overall, as a singer, as a lead man, as a composer, as an instrumentalist, everything.
He's a beautiful human being in every respect. And I'm very pleased that we've given him an opportunity to show what he can do. I mean, it's an opportunity that arose because of a desperate tragedy. So, you know, we're all sorry that happened. We're all desperately sorry that happened, but he's been, you know, he has, and, you know, but that, because that tragedy did happen, that in itself made the whole, him taking on that burden almost, a very difficult thing. And as I've said to you before, you know, one of my main things is let's not try and get a replica voice for David. Let's not try and replace him directly. Let's bring somebody in that has their own sound, but most importantly can also convey emotional content of songs, which is what he does. And I wish I wasn't working with him, because then I wouldn't have lost David. But on the other hand, I can't unhappen what happened. And he's given me an opportunity to, you know, to continue in music. So I'm very grateful to him, because I think he's a gentleman, and he's handled himself with absolute aplomb in what it must be an incredibly difficult situation for him to deal with. So yeah, hats off to him.
I think that's, do you still feel that that is up for debate? Every now and then you come across a line on a post on the Facebook, you know, page, someone says, oh, well, you know, Alberto's great, but.
Yeah. And I think that will always be the case. And I don't think he or I take it personally. You know, Dave was an amazing human being and an amazing singer and a massive part of the band. So, you know, some people will say, okay, that's how I see Big Big Train, and I can't. You know, I think some people genuinely struggle to move on. I think what I would ask of them is that they, you know, keep an open heart, and maybe give the new album and the new singer, you know, a little bit of their time to see if they. You know, if time enables them to listen with ears that are open rather than, you know, close to, you know, the future story of the band. So, but I do get it, and I don't, you know, neither of us, you know, it's one, it just is, it is what it is. You know, we can't, you know, it's been, as I said to you in the last thing, it wasn't really until late on in the tour that I felt really confident that we had, you know, that continuing the band was actually the right thing to do, you know. And I think everyone's got a process to go through. It's a process, you know, us close to it. It's an extraordinarily hard grieving thing to do. But then one of the ways you deal with it is to throw yourself into work, you know, and we're no different from anybody else in that, you know, you throw yourself into something. And I'm not a half-hearted person. If I'm going to do something, I'll do it to the nth degree. Otherwise, there's no point for me. So, you know, when we decided to carry the band on, we were always going to be, you know, going for it. Because otherwise, it would just be a sad ending, I think, just to kind of peter out. And I didn't want that to happen to us.